Please stand, if you would.
As the mountains surround Jerusalem, so the Lord surrounds His people. As the mountains surround Jerusalem, so the Lord surrounds His people.
Colossians chapter 3 and verse 16 says, "Let the word of Christ richly dwell within you, teaching and admonishing one another with psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, singing with grace in your hearts to the Lord." Tonight our singing is going to focus on the theme of grace, the grace that God has given to us and the grace that fills our heart. It's so great to have all of you here with us. I'm going to lead us in prayer to get started this evening. Before I do, for those of you who are a part of our regular Valrico family, we do want to be especially mindful of our good brother Ralph Acock, who will have procedures done this Tuesday, hopefully to open up more of the blood vessels in his heart. So we're going to be praying for him and for Sandy and all the family. Let's go to God in prayer. We are so grateful, Father, to be your people, to be called by grace, to be called for a plan that existed before this world even began. To know, Father, that you have loved us from all eternity is overwhelming. And to know, Father, that by the abundant riches of your grace, your gift, through your Son, Jesus Christ, we could all be together here tonight as your people. Father, we realize our imperfections. We realize that we fall short and we make mistakes. So as we begin this evening, Father, we ask you, please, to cleanse our hearts of all sin, to drive away distractions from our mind, to help us, Father, come to you in a way that is fitting the one true and living God. We thank you, Father, so much for our brother Ralph and for the recovery he's enjoyed so far. We do pray for your blessings, for the surgeons, those who will be attending to him on Tuesday. We pray for a successful procedure so that he could have a fuller measure of health. We're thankful for him and all of our shepherds. We're thankful for our deacons, for all of their families. We thank you, Father, for every family of ours at Valrico represented here tonight. And we're very thankful for every visitor who's here with us. Bless us, Father, to have hearts filled with grace and return to you the grace that you've given to us. We pray in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Ephesians chapter 2. It's page number 917 in the Pew Bible. And you were dead in the trespasses and sins in which you once walked, following the course of this world, following the prince of the power of the air, the spirit that is now at work in the sons of disobedience, among whom we all once lived in the passions of our flesh, carrying out the desires of the body and of the mind, and were by nature children of wrath, like the rest of mankind. But God, being rich in mercy, because of the great love with which he loved us, even when we were dead in our trespasses, made us alive together with Christ. By grace you have been saved.
We'll focus on what God has saved us from in this first section. We'll begin with "Just As I Am."
Just as
not been the Lord.
Yeah.
Lord, help me rise up again.
The next song we're going to sing is "The Rock of My Heart."
Without you, I could not have stood.
The next song we're going to sing is I Could Not Do Without You. The next song in this section, the last song in this section, is Turn Your Eyes Upon Jesus.
Through death into life everlasting. The scripture reading for the second section is going to be Ephesians 2, 5 through 9. Even when we were dead in our trespasses, made us alive together with Christ. By grace you have been saved, and raised up with him, and seated us with him in the heavenly places in Christ Jesus, so that in the coming day he might show the immeasurable riches of his grace and kindness toward us in Christ Jesus. For by grace you have been saved through faith. And this is not your own doing. It is the gift of God, not a result of works, so that no one may boast. For we are his workmanship, created in Christ Jesus for good works, which God prepared beforehand, that we should walk in them.
O thou fount of every blessing.
O thou fount of every blessing, to my heart to sing thy praise, streams of mercy never ceasing,
we put together a virtual video to sing in quarantine, and so that makes it all the more special to sing it with you all in person now. His grace reaches me. Beautiful song.
Just to feel and to know. Complete in thee the work of mine. Good and dear Lord, the place of mine. Thy heart and heart and love for me. And our trust and complete in thee. Yet blessed light, O blessed law, and sanctified salvation brought. Thy blood and heart and love for me.
Before the throne of God above,
my name is Ray, my God is.
next song we're going to sing is Mended and Whole.
Oh, how great the salvation in Jesus, and the prophets of old testify. The angels desire is revealing, praise and glory to Christ crucified.
You have risen for me, your splendor for me, every thorn, every nail, every tear was for me, sweet the thought.
Wonderful grace of Jesus. We will sing all three verses and then the chorus at the end.
Wonderful grace of Jesus, greater than all my sin. Thank you.
Introduce the third section of serving grace. We're going to be reading from the book of Titus, chapter 2. Titus chapter 2, we're going to begin in verse 11. For the grace of God has appeared, bringing salvation for all people, training us to renounce ungodliness and worldly passions, and to live self-controlled, upright, and godly lives in the present age, waiting for our blessed hope, the appearing of the glory of our great God and Savior Jesus Christ, who gave himself for us to redeem us from all lawlessness and to purify for himself a people for his own possession who are zealous for good works.
He is able. Please stand if you would. Maybe the first song I ever remember leading at us singing. So anyway, it fits perfectly in with our theme. Let me live close to thee.
In thy field, by the fields, it was great and true. In the fight for the right, I would dare and do. Spend my days in thy praise, all the journey.
Let me live close to thee.
Abba, Father.
Reign in me.
Yeah.
Some of you young people may not know this song. This one comes from the old Sacred Selections book. Living by Faith.
I care not today what the tomorrow may bring.
Beautiful life. When looking at all the verses, this is such a long song, we did not want to cut any verses. So we are going to sing verses 1 and 2, then the chorus, 3 and 4, and then the chorus.
Each day I'll do
I'm not afraid. Amen. I hope all of you were edified. I know I was. It is so wonderful to see so many out here. I want to thank all of you for coming out for our song service, especially all of you students. You really helped boost up our song. It's really great to have you. Want to make sure we encourage all of you that are willing and able to be out Sunday morning. We'll have our 9:30 communion service. 10:30 will be Bible classes for all ages. And 11:30 will be our praise service. So make sure that you make plans to be here Sunday as well, if you can. I'm going to say a closing prayer, and then we'll have a closing song after our closing prayer. So if you would, please bow with me. I'll say a closing prayer. Dear God, how great and mighty is your name. We thank you so much for all of the bountiful blessings that you've given to us. We thank you for this opportunity we had to gather together and sing praises to your name. We know that we were edified, but we also pray that everything that we did was pleasing unto you. That's our purpose tonight. We thank you so much this evening for grace, for it is by grace that we are saved. We know that your grace lifts us, and your grace gives us the opportunity to be saved and to have that, to be able to look forward to a life, an everlasting life in heaven with you. We know it's because of grace that we have dedicated our lives to serving you and doing everything to praise your name. We ask as we leave here this evening that we will manifest that grace through our works, and that everything we do will show how much it means to be a Christian and help us to teach others your word and show them the example of Christ and how Christ lives in us. We ask all this in Christ's name. Amen.
Why don't we stand for this closing song? The Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord lift his countenance upon you and give you peace. May the Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. No.